The rise of cryptocurrency making headlines around the world.
What started as an idea over a dozen years ago is now worth billions of dollars. WGN's Sean Lewis joins us now with some of the basics. Basics, please, because a lot of people still clueless.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I did a lot of research, and some of the things are still a little bit iffy to me, too.
Uh-oh.
Well, no, but I think we're going to get down the basics
okay,
at least
cool.
tonight. All right, you know, sometimes it's not easy to explain an idea, especially when you can't touch it, you can't see it, but you can't deny those billions of dollars that Bitcoin and other cryptocurrencies are now worth. So we found out why. In a world so busy, so full of questions about everything, there's one that, for many, at least recently, tops the list.
What is Bitcoin?
Allie Ballard is certainly not alone in her curiosity on cryptocurrency like Bitcoin.
I don't really understand what cryptocurrency is. I don't understand what I'm investing in, and I have never not understood what I'm investing in.
Allie is a Chicago realtor and looks at crypto from a pretty common perspective.
I sell a house, right? That's a house. It has bricks, it has floors, it has a refrigerator, it has, I mean, you live in it. A Bitcoin?
To find some answers, we went to some experts.
The thing about crypto is that it is nothing like what has existed before.
Julie Alma-Taveras teaches personal finance, one aspect of which is cryptocurrency. That is the umbrella term for digital forms of payment that can be used online to buy goods and services. There are now thousands of cryptos out there. The granddaddy, of course, is Bitcoin, which boils down to a computer code with no centralized regulation and was written by a faceless person or group of people known as Satoshi Nakamoto. It started in 2009 in the wake of the financial crisis.
If the system worked, there wouldn't be Bitcoin. And that is the most powerful, profound statement when it comes to all of this.
Tyrone Ross has watched Bitcoin and crypto grow a lot in the last year, including one making a lot of news and a lot of money in the last few months, Dogecoin, going from less than a penny each in January and reaching more than 40 cents just this week after many mentions in tweets from Elon Musk. It's gone up more than 1,000%. Not bad for a digital coin whose mascot is a dog.
It truly is. It started out as a joke, a dog meme, and I've gotten a lot of text messages about it. It did start off as a joke, and now it's become like a real thing.
He sees crypto and the way it is mined online, a technology called blockchain, as a game changer to level the financial field for those who are often left out and overlooked.
I run my company based on how the Bitcoin blockchain runs. Like, we run our internal company meetings just like the Bitcoin blockchain. So every 10 minutes, a new block is mined, right? We stop every meeting 10 minutes to make sure that there's consensus. Does everybody understand what's going on? Not until then can we move on. Why? Because every block in a blockchain, there cannot be a new block created until the previous block, everyone agrees. Great, consensus, cool. We'll move on to the next block.
Which leads us here, what's known as a Bitcoin farm. Much like a gold mine where people chip away at rock to find gold, hundreds and sometimes thousands of computer servers are running around the clock, mining, chipping away at computer code to unlock Bitcoin and other crypto.
Bitcoin mining is a process of confirming transactions.
Sergey Gorosimovich is one of those Bitcoin miners.
How much energy does it take to mine a Bitcoin?
For one Bitcoin, look, I cannot tell you how much it will take to mine one Bitcoin, but I can tell you that the whole Bitcoin mining network uses around 8 to 9 gigawatts of power constantly, which is a large number. It is more probably than the whole Argentina uses.
One small server like this one can mine about $150 in Bitcoin every month, but it costs about as much to run it if you plug it into the wall at your home. To cut costs and their carbon footprint, his company, Easy Blockchain, uses these mobile data centers filled with hundreds of servers and powered by a generator, running it right off the source of energy in the oil fields on what he calls wasted energy.
I'm talking about natural gas, which is a byproduct of oil drilling. So we utilize that natural gas for cryptocurrency mining, meaning we kill two birds with one stone. We help oil and gas companies to utilize their flaring, as well as we mine clean Bitcoin because we are not utilizing any of the grid energy.
Once the Bitcoin is mined, it goes into the public marketplace on a ledger, it's called, where it is bought and sold, and everyone, and we mean everyone, can keep an eye on it. Out of the 21 million Bitcoin in the code, about 18.5 million have already been mined.
And that's what makes it really cool and really interesting. And it's the reason why people trust it more. I feel like you can trust numbers more than you can trust people.
In Edgewater,
I have my little command center over here where I'm constantly monitoring my cryptocurrency.
Nicholas Zahn, a fine arts framer by trade, is also now a crypto enthusiast. He started buying it just a year ago.
Crypto has worked out really well. I made my initial investment and I am up, very up.
How up? Percentage-wise.
Recently, we were up 600%.
Wow.
Which is a lot, more than I expected.
Yes, it's hard to look at those type of returns and people not want to chase that. It's just human nature.
But they say be careful.
When you're buying a crypto, there's no underlying value to it. The value is a supply and demand value.
Crypto experts like Dennis Chukasian say there is a lot of risk in something this new and this unknown.
So anyone who is buying it needs to be very cautious to understand that there's no floor that supports a lower level price. The price could be zero on any of those cryptos, and it could be much, much higher than it is right now. So it's a trading asset, not an investment asset.
All of this is still something that is speculative. We're still seriously in the infancy stage of what cryptocurrency is.
Buying and selling crypto may not be for everyone.
I feel anxiety. I check it every 5 minutes.
Remember our realtor, Allie? She's being cautious.
In my head, I want to leave the $1,500 for 10 years. We'll see what happens.
For others, it's not about investing in crypto itself.
I do think that more and more we're going to see that a lot of services, a lot of products are going to be designed to be bought in Bitcoin.
It is more about what it represents as an agent of change.
It's going to mean freedom for a lot of people that have never had it. And not necessarily freedom to drive a Bentley and have a $5 million house, but the freedom to take care of their family on their terms and get access and instant settlement and be able to access money cheaply and not have it be so expensive to be poor in this country. That, those are the things that everyone should get excited about. Change is going to come, and it's coming quicker than people think.
Sounds good.
Of course it does. Everything looks good when it's up making money, at least that's the case right now. But the experts will be the first to tell you what goes up can come down, and be very careful with any type of investment, especially something volatile like cryptocurrency. It trades every moment of every day, so you have to keep your eyes on it 24/7. The first step, of course, should be educating yourself on how to do this if you want to. We have some resources set up at WGNTV.com, and I see your eye right now.
I've been asking you questions throughout the whole piece because it's confusing. It's nothing tangible like money.
It's not tangible, but then again, how often do we carry around cash these days?
But we know where the cash is, and we've seen it.
Well, it was backed by faith back then, and this is, digital faith.
Exactly.
Right?
Exactly. You know, if you go back 200 years, you had banks that had their own cash back in the day.
Gold.
So this is just a new version of that.
Can you get rich?
A lot of people have made some money.
Okay. Because Tyrone says that that's the way of the future.
Yeah, we'll see. We'll see.
Okay. If you could work up another piece for next week and for more questions and answers, we'll see you then, okay?
Get done with that.
Thank you, Sean.
Appreciate it.
Thanks. See you later. Yeah.